Bang, another one. Here we are. What up?
Number 6, back at it on the couch, early morning.
Yeah, it's definitely early morning. It is, once again, what, half past seven in the morning on a Friday morning. How are we all, ladies and gentlemen? Hope we're doing good out there. Schmino, how you doing, Cobb?
Yeah, not too bad, Cobber. Just same deal.
I'm nice fucking tired, I'll tell you that much.
I was going to say you look like you're a little bit... behind the eight ball this morning, Shane.
Yeah, a little bit there, Cobb. But we're not bad. Let's kick her off, I guess, in a sense of like a few little mad little things for the podcast. It's obviously been a little bit turning a few heads and getting a little bit of attention, which is super dope because we've had someone hit us up and we've got our first official sponsor for the podcast. Fuck yeah, you know it. So, massive shout out to Bacchus Marsh Tint. What the go is they've actually supplied us a new microphone because we've obviously, if you've been listening to the podcast, there's been a few microphone issues with Big Schmido over there.
Down on my end.
One being he needs to learn how to talk into the microphone. Two being the microphone's probably not the best for this situation. It's an old fucking condenser mic and it's...
We need a dynamic.
This is correct. But we're here and we're making it happen. The mic we don't actually have yet. We're in the mix of getting it. So hopefully we'll have it by the next podcast. Things have just been super busy. But we also thought we're still here to give them a good old shout out because they were the first ones to jump on board and we respect the fuck out of that.
Appreciate the hell out of it.
Bacchus Marsh Tint. Make sure if you need your tinting done, give them a buzz. Local Bacchus Marshians, good dudes, Milsons.
But... in the same time, they don't do your automobiles. They only do your homes, offices, businesses.
That's correct.
Whatever you want.
Don't hit them up and be like, can you fucking tint me Falcon? Because they'll tell you to fuck off.
Go down to Tinnacar, mate.
That's it. If you want your bloody nice alfresco doors tinted, though, call them.
Hey.
That is where it's at. Yeah, and I guess ongoing on that, I guess there's it's awesome to be like, obviously, if you do have some sort of company and you do want us to talk a bit of shit about you or whatever, we can totally work something out. Hit us up. We'll do some talking. We'll do some deals and we'll sort some stuff out. Like I've said before, there are a few other things that we need to get sorted for the podcast. So if we can all work together on that and you get a bit of a shout out or whatever, we're totally happy to be doing those sorts of things. And, just sort of on that note too, with the whole support thing, it's just the support recently has just been
huge,
overwhelmingly awesome. Especially with things like the podcast and stuff. In saying all this, I did sort of put a little bit of a video up about the you know, and in last week's podcast about, you know, like the secret followers and stuff. And I guess I didn't just touch on the fact of like there's that side, but there's also a huge side of like support. A huge, constantly getting like messages where it's obviously, you know, the podcast and whatever we're doing is making a difference, and that's sort of all that matters to us, I guess.
It definitely does. I almost reckon that it's been pretty much, I can say personally, that I've almost got a message a day saying,
yeah,
you know, man, this is sick, thanks, either thanks for doing it or I appreciate you doing it. You don't understand how much it's helped me day to day since you've started doing it, or it's fallen into place at the best time because I've needed something like this and I can relate to you guys. And
stories that, you know, we'll get hit up about, you know, everyone will have their own little story and, you know, we'll cop messages that is like, this is how, what I'm dealing with or what I had to deal with and now I'm here or I'm going through this process
or I'm now talking about it because I feel that it's a good thing to do because yous are showing me that it can be done.
There's a lot of that sort of coming back to be like, you know, I might go home and tackle this sort of problem now because I do see it from a different perspective and I guess all that sort of stuff is good. Going back on what I was sort of saying about having, I guess, the little bit of the rant, it's more just like, I see it all.
I was going to say, we both see it all.
I try my hardest to respond to all those sorts of fucking messages and keep in the loop with you guys because at the end of the day, that's what sort of keeps me going. It's the inspiration for me. Like, I get inspiration from you guys. Like, that's pretty much how it is. So, on that note, just a massive thanks to everyone that does put in the support, everyone out there watching the videos, that does subscribe, that has listened to all the podcasts, that does buy a t-shirt, that is a patron. All you dudes and ladies, gents, all you legends are the reason why all this shit is happening. It's moving harder. It's getting bigger. And I literally cannot thank all yous enough for it because
it wouldn't be happening. It would not be happening if it wasn't for the support from you guys.
100%. On that note, you know, with going on support, still just talking about things that have been sort of going on and stuff, like the colouring competition was like another huge eye-opener to be like how good the support.
Yeah, to feel how much of a push we've got behind us when we're doing something like that.
And an influence, and like using that influence like in the right way, you know, like for a long time, it's sort of always been these whole like, you know, influences and but I guess until you actually influence someone and you see the effect it can have, then that's when you sort of become a real influencer, I think, like so. Now that we're in that position to be able to do that, it's...
Well, we've got the ground that people can actually
trust
and listen and be like, oh, okay, take a little bit from their book or whatever, because they know the stories they're hearing are fucking legit.
Yep.
And I think that's one of the biggest things coming back on people hitting us up. It's like, use a raw.
Yeah.
I don't reckon I've seen raw this much in messages
in
my whole life.
Yeah.
Let alone, you know?
Yeah, yeah, that's a lot of the fact that we do just... There's no
real
bullshit.
Raw.
And that's just who we are. It's always sort of what we've sort of been about. There's no bullshit, straight to the point, keep it fucking real, and obviously it's resonating with a lot of people, and yeah, well, we do, we respect that. And on the coloring competition, if we can ease our way into the younger generation and influence them in the right ways and the things that we've learned the hard way, I guess. And I still go back to, we all have to learn our own way, but at least if we can be that little bit of a guidance to be like, look, that path might be fucky, but go for it, but be ready to be, you know, knocked on the head a couple of times. They can go into it with that thing rather than being like blind, like we were as kids going into things going, it's all going to be roses. It's probably not.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And so, people that are close to you in those times when you're a kid don't really want to tell you the truth. They want to just, you know, where it's good to hear the truth, man. You need to fucking hear the truth, whether it hurts or not. But, as well on the colouring comp side of things, just obviously it was pretty kid related, don't get me wrong, there was a fair few adults that jumped in and got on board, but that's all good. With the kids side of things, I think that's, yeah, like Borgs was just saying, that's a good thing, like for both of us to focus on, and we want to focus on and push in that direction of basically, yeah, giving them a platform to be able to watch on people that have got a fair idea on living and the world and all that, but yeah, just being able to provide that for them, because I don't think there's many levels of let's say influences for kids and Aussie younger kids.
And I think, and if I guess if they are, I think I'd like to just sort of like really slip in that happy medium of kids stuff, not, you know, I don't think we're going to be doing play schools.
Hell no. Like, don't get me wrong. And it's great to be able to put it out there for all the adults too, that all,
for sure,
that, all people on our level.
You know, I wouldn't mind finding that happy medium of like live Goosebumps, if you will. That age of kid, you know, teenagers coming into that, right before that stage where you become a little piece of shit.
Yeah, so like 11, 12, 13.
Yeah, that where you froth things are cool, and at least right before that point where you do become a little bit of a piece of shit, which just naturally happens as a teenage man. If you don't think you were a piece of shit, then come on, man. Like, you did some fucky shit, and we all did. But I think right before that stage, if you can get a little bit of the right influence in there, at least you can move through that stage with a wise head on you. And I think, you know, I think I might have been in some stages lucky enough to have a few of those that kept me a little bit above water, a few of the right influence that made me go, probably don't want to go down that path. I'd rather stick down this path because it does look like it ends up being better.
Definitely. You know, I think we were lucky in that sense too. We did have a lot of older people around, like mates or mates' brothers that are older. So we modeled off them.
Yep.
And that was always sick because to have older people around to be like, oh, okay, that's like that, or they don't do that for that reason, or just an understanding on absolutely everything in that sense is really good to have. And I understand that a lot of kids don't have that.
Yeah.
And they may not have that. So if they can jump on the internet, because we've all got that, and fucking jump on, search our stuff, and have a look. Like, yeah, it's something that I think will be pretty beneficial for young dudes and chicks out there.
Definitely. And, you know, just sort of being the sort of dudes we are, almost going off the phase we did with Link, your nephew. Like, yep. I think we can, we're not fathers. We don't have that. We don't understand what dads understand. I think we can see it. We'll never understand it until the times come, and I'll be the first one to admit that. But we see that you know, there's something different when you become a fucking father.
Yep.
But I think we do have a natural and whatever, I'll just say, like, we're cool uncles. And if we can be that for random people that might not have any of that, they might not even have dad in the picture, for instance. They might not have mum in the picture. There could be some sort of definite situation where they just need a bit of, like, moral elder support. That's still not like an old person telling them what to do. We've still got that, like, funkiness that makes us go, sure. Oh, they're still doing cool shit.
Definitely. There's so all that side of it. And
if we can, you know, open kids up to that, that's I, you know.
For sure.
It is. It's like, I'm doing my job. And like you almost said too, if you can get a message a day from someone and they're grateful from you just talking some shit on a podcast, then man, fuck, job's done.
Definitely.
That's the real winner here.
100%. And like it, in going back to a few of those messages, a lot of it was keep doing what you're doing. It's a big chunk of
pushing us to keep pushing.
Yeah,
is a big,
definitely.
Yeah,
I can't remember the phrase that was used, but it's like it's a bunch of fresh air. Basically, keep doing what you're doing. Don't stop because it's fucking it's good. And I think that will flip over to the kids' side of things.
Yeah,
if they're adults and parents are taking that in on that, like, on that level.
Yep.
Well, then I think unknowingly the kids will take that on and take it in like that. They probably won't know at the time that it is, like, you know, they're hearing that and it makes them feel good or whatever, or gives them a little bit more hope. Whether they know that or not at the time, I just think it is an all-round good help and a good idea just to poke into those directions a little bit.
Yeah, and it's beneficial. It does it. It makes it's one of those little bit of a full circle thing where everyone can feel good and
definitely. But
if we can make each other feel good, then that's what we're all about.
100%. So yeah, we love the support, dudes, and thank you for the big push behind the colouring comp. Yeah,
and I in saying it too, like, obviously thanking for all the support is a massive thing, but, like, you know, we're huge appreciation to those messages we do get that are like, you know, use drop your walls a little bit and throw a little bit of stuff on us. Like, we do see you guys doing that shit, and, you know, sometimes it can be a little bit hard to reply to those sometimes because, you know, you don't fully understand, or, you know, you've just got to be like, keep trucking in a sense. But the fact that you've opened up to us is a huge step for you guys, and we don't not see, like, I mean, 99.99% of the time I try to reply to everything, but it is. It's like, don't sort of hold back because you think you won't get a reply, or you think I'm going to look at you stupidly or something like that. It's
we're here.
It works, and it does. It's leaps and bounds. So don't be scared to just flick us a text, and if we can shoot you in the right way, we'll try and shoot you in the right way.
Yeah, like, we are human beings. We don't bite, and we're putting it out there. We are here to help if we can. So we're not going to be the ones to not help if you just come to us with that.
What else has been going on?
Just pretty much
what's happened since last week, Matt? What have you been doing since the last week?
Me personally, I've obviously just been still in the shop working mechanic and loving that, learning heaps, bloody doing the things I've always, I guess, wanted to do. But that's just, I've had a couple of days off in the last week since we've been here, sitting here last, and that's just due to a few things that I basically had to sit down and work out and get on the roll for a couple of things that we've got in the pipelines that I think is happening quite soon, which is pretty exciting. I don't want to dive into that much and to talk about much just because, it's going to be pretty cool once it happens. You all know about it.
If I started talking about it, I reckon I'd just ooze froth. I'd just be
definitely.
Like,
that's
I'd start
why
talking
I don't
about
think...
it and it'd just go... Because it's just all the froth coming out of my mouth for these future endeavours.
So that's pretty much on my side, man. It hasn't been a very exciting in the way of doing crazy cool things, but pretty much just getting it all ready and in line and down on paper, so when it is time, all these crazy and cool things can happen, and they're going to be able to happen quite easily and good.
Bit of theory sesh, Schmido. A bit of theory.
Yeah, pretty much. Just to get all these cool things.
Hands off the tools in the office, doing the bloody
phone calls, bloody emails, getting all me things, bits and pieces, documents together, basically.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's on my side. That's about all. Shana, what about yourself there, Cobb?
Yeah, all sorts. I've sort of been a little bit. I've almost had another. I've been in a bit of a weird limbo week. I've had a little bit of Ace Colour issues. Have been a little bit weird. They've been a little bit low on stock on some things with all the shiznit going on. So that was a little bit of an issue.
I think everyone's feeling that, eh?
Yeah, there's little bits and pieces everywhere that are suddenly unavailable for a while there, and it's
everything's going on back order.
It's a bit of an eye opener. If your eyes are open enough, you will actually sort of start seeing and working out why all this is going on. But at the same time, yeah, that was a little bit of a hold up for a week or so. I just couldn't get a bunch of stock, so I just had a bunch of jobs on back order, and it was a little bit of a, well, I guess it was probably like first time for something like that for me. I've been pretty consistent,
lucky.
Yeah, and lucky. And, you know, it was one of those things where I had to just accept it and, like, it's out of my hand. Like, I'm sort of like, if I get a job, I'll fucking try and get it in there, get it done, make it happen, get it out. So, like, the fact that I had to sit on a few of them was a little bit of a jam for me. But I sort of obviously just worked through it. I've had plenty of other... I've been doing all the new sort of MDP drop. There's a bunch of... I've got a whole...
I was going to say, Shana, you're looking pretty fresh over there.
Yeah, if you're watching this on the Patreon, or maybe it's come out on YouTube and it's a couple weeks later. If it's a couple weeks later on the YouTube, I've probably already dropped this, but the patrons have probably seen it a little bit early. But yeah, I got a couple of little fresh whole get up on. Got the trackies on, got the t-shirt.
Jump up, man. Jump up. Show us.
I've got to jump up anyway because I just realized one of those cameras is
died on
us. So
fair enough. But yeah, I'll keep dribbling on here. Yeah, so pretty much Borgs has been working fucking hard on a new line of clothes, and they're pretty dope. Yeah, a bit of a new design, new feel, new flow to it all, and I guess he's reached out to that and dove into it. So it's all new grounds for him, I guess, in the way of new designs. But the clothing is still the quality you guys know behind the MDP name. There's nothing better in that sense.
Yeah.
And yeah, pretty much. You can tell them what you've done as such, Shana. In the way of the design, if you want. I don't know.
My bloody camera's just died on me again. I don't know what's going on. Righto, it's spare cam. Let's go.
Here he is. He's on the pit stop. It's on.
But here we are. And hopefully that's sorted. We're back on camera so you guys can watch this back in your homes later on.
So, yeah, what feel did you go for, Borgs? You've obviously gone for a new style of logo and whatnot. A
little bit. There's a couple of little drops in there that are a little bit, I'll go with the main drop, which is almost, I like to sort of call it the class of 2020 range, if you will. I guess it started off with the big project of it, having the opportunity to get the sort of jacket I was after.
Yep.
Which then inspired it, you know. Well, I guess I'm sort of into it now, but I'm sort of in the mix of doing like a big dope college jacket. And that sort of inspired a couple of logos, and then it sort of pushed it into this whole sort of range where I did. And, you know, I don't know, I've had this weird little buzz at the end of the day. Here we are. We're on the podcast. We're fucking schooling motherfuckers.
Yeah,
so why not bring out a bloody bit of a might die high range, if you will. So,
definitely.
Yeah, I've sort of pumped into this. It is a little bit different. It's a lot more. I like, you know, all my tag stuff's pretty clean, and a few of my stuff I like to sort of make them clean or like super messy, and I think these ones fall into the super clean category. They're pretty fucking fancy. A few little different things, bit of chrome in there that just throws it off. That's just a little bit different. And yeah, I'm sort of pretty stoked on the new drop. But in saying that, there's also, you know, we go back to like Schmidt had a fucking sick idea a couple of months ago about just like location wise for a hoodie, jumper, t-shirt, whatever,
yeah, yeah.
And he's sort of like, can you fucking put some prints up here or whatever, and we'll fucking try some shit like that. So we had a little bit of a play, and that worked, and I think that's a lot more might die style.
Yeah.
It's a little bit more...
custom
and a little bit more dirty, if you will. But it's also got I'm really stoked in that just because it is something a little bit different. I'm a big fan of, like, I don't know, I actually do like other people's ideas, and if people are willing to, like, work ideas with you, I think, like, there's nothing better than, like, teamwork idea.
100%.
And I think that's why I like that one heaps, because it was sort of like you threw that at me and I was like, oh, you could do that, and then we sort of talked about it a little bit. I did a few designs and it was sort of like, what do you reckon? It's sort of like maybe a bit of this. Drips and all that sort of thing was spoken about. Yep. So it's almost like we just found, like, this nice happy medium. And we're like, fuck.
And it kind of worked.
Yeah, really well, man. Like, it's fucking... Because
that can be a pretty... That can be a pretty fucky process of laying that, especially a different position. I've seen you...
It can look... You know, things can just not look right real easily.
Yep, definitely. And, I guess just lightly on that too. Yeah, you did. You took that, my...
Idea
on, and you're just like, yeah, fuck yeah, and you tried it out and whatnot. So I guess people could be very stubborn to that and be like, you can't fucking have input to my shit, where you're real open with that and was like, fuck yeah, take that on, I'll try it at least and see what it looks like. Fuck, it actually looks pretty cool, let's do it. So yeah, that's real cool to fucking see, and I guess that's a cool thing to be around and be a part of, because you feel, you know, You put your input in, and then you take it on and you go and do something with it, and now it's a fucking shirt.
Yeah.
It's fucking cool.
Yeah. And yeah, so they're all, it's the old new little merch drop has been, it's such a fucking full on tedious process, man, you know, like, because it goes from being initial design, so you design the fucking new logo or whatever you want to use again, and then it's, you got to make all the screens for the test prints, then, like, and in saying all this, you know, you don't really know. You're testing on, you've got to really work out what colors, what garments you're working with. Like, order all them, have them sitting there. Then you've got to test print them. That's got to work. You know, you might buy 4 green hoodies and you print on them and it looks like shit. You got to go back to sort of square one. I think, if anything, I was pretty sort of lucky with this shit. It all went smooth. I think I picked the right colors and they all match. Well, I'm happy with them, so then at the end of the day, that's sort of all that matters when I'm doing my own thing. But yeah, it can just get pretty, you know, then you've got to then print all the samples and then bring them all back here, set it up in front of the green screen, take photos of everything, put them on the computer, Photoshop everything, pull them all down, make the artwork for the website. So like it's a very sort of tedious, I mean, I'm getting there. Most of it's done. I've just got a few other little shirts and stuff that I want to add if I'm going to drop a bunch of new stuff, because obviously the kids' stuff's coming in as well. I just wouldn't mind clearing it all up. So I'm sort of hoping, to be honest, maybe end of next week I've got a lot of that sorted and I'll sort of drop it at the end of next week or something. What have we got on dates these days? Is there a nice date at the end of the week? I like dropping my stuff on weird random dates and stuff. I like
making it a little bit unique on the time.
The right numbers sometimes. Well, I guess next week, what are we going, June? No, not really, but maybe we'll just even go like the 1st or the 30th or end of next week or something, we'll sort of try and aim for. But yeah, so be in the mix for some new gear, because it's dope as fuck. There's some big shit dropping. These trackies are fucking boss ass.
Perfect for winter. Perfect for winter.
And it is. It's a lot of sort of, based on sort of, you know, a bit of baggy sweats style, I guess. Just baggy, comfy, good clothes.
And we love our baggy sweats.
You know that. That's sort of it for, I mean, it's all happening. You're going to have to keep on the ball to sort of see some new stuff. So you know where to go, livediefree.com. You know where it is when all that stuff's dropping. There'll be some photos popping around. You'll know when it's out. So just be onto it and be the first in that fresh class of 2000. Schooled.
100%, man. 100%.
What else has been going? That's about...
I'll just jump in here quickly just because we didn't say it before, but basically with Bacchus Marsh Tint, again, these dudes, they're great. They've sponsored us and we appreciate the hell out of it. So basically, Bacchus Marsh Tint, they're www.bacchusmarsh, B-A-C-C-H-U-S-M-A-R-S-H, tint, tint.com.au. And they basically say, we at Bacchus Marsh Tint offer all types of window film for residential applications. Also, we do commercial installations such as foyers. So get around them. Don't hit them up. Ask them for car tinting. They won't do it. Don't do it.
If you're building a new house, and you want to, like I said, you need your alfresco tinted, call them dudes. You guys are killing it on that shout-out level too, because like we're going to have to give you another shout-out next weekend when we're actually talking about the mic that you've supplied. So, yeah.
First one. You know, we've got to look after the people.
Yeah, and like that's I am that sort of person, you know, like the fact that he's sort of approached me with it, like I give that respect, so I'm going to give a little, you know. When someone gives me an inch, if I can give him a mile, I will.
If you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
That's exactly right. But I guess this is probably our biggest topic of, like, we're about 25 minutes in, so I think we could wall for a while. Now, within the last week, we had a little bit of an episode. It could have even been the day after or 2 days after the last podcast.
Yeah, I think it was pretty soon after that.
How do we start this off? Because what a little
the noises.
Experience it was.
Just the noises.
Yeah, so I guess for a couple of nights there, I was hearing some noises. And I don't know, I end up sort of staying up pretty late. Yeah, I just end up, I'm a bit of a night owl. So, like, you know, Schmidt will be going to bed already or whatever, and I'm just sitting up daydreaming or whatever I do. It's night dreaming, but I'm awake. But, and yeah, a few little...
And where is that?
Yeah, and so I'm like, pretty sure it's fucking in the roof. Pretty sure there's a fucking mouse in the roof. This is fucking shit. And I reckon I might have said something to Schmidt. I'm like, fucking swear there might be some sort of mouse getting around in the roof there, Cobb. He's like, oh, yeah, righto. Anyway, this is, like I said, it went on for a couple of nights there, and I was sort of hearing a few things here and there and was starting to put shit together. And then this night comes, and it's 12 o'clock probably. I think.
Yeah, it was definitely getting late.
It was definitely pretty late. It was almost probably maybe over past 12 o'clock. I'm doing my thing again, maybe just watching something on the YouTube, probably maybe just on my phone, maybe just staring into nothing, daydreaming, night dreaming at night, whatever you want to call it. Schmidt's a little bit fucking on the couch. He's just passed his ass out. It's fucking past his bedtime and he didn't want to drag himself to bed, so he thought it'd be a good place to snooze on the couch. So he's just like neck back, fucking mouth open, as you normally do when you're sleeping on the couch. And
was my mouth open?
Probably. I don't know. You feel like you always sleep with your mouth open. You're just one of those cunts that always just goes
fuck off.
But and then next thing, there was a bit of noise, right? And so he's asleep on the couch, and I'm sort of awake, just like, what the fuck? And get up off my phone to sort of be like, what the fuck was that noise? And it was a few just, maybe, or something like that, a few little ratty-tats.
Bit of porcelain touching.
Yeah, and then, so, long story short, for a while there, I was saving up a bunch of V-cans. I was going to do this little thing, right? Anyway, there's like a bag full of empty V-cans under the sink. Next thing I know, I hear that. So you imagine that, just fucking empty cans. And I'm like, what the fuck was that? Like, it was loud enough to be like, what the fuck was that? So I wake this cunt up, I'm like, oi, fucking wake up, cunt. And then I reckon as I was waking him up, he was coming to, I reckon there was another little bit of a...
Yeah, there was a...
Bit of like a couple of bowls tapping each other and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, what? I'm like, fuck, bro, can you fucking hear that? Like...
I've woken up and haven't said a word. Like, my eyes have opened and I've just, like, paused. I'm silent, waiting for this noise. Like, fuck, where is it? What's happened? And, yeah, a couple more scratches up there. I was like, fuck, so there is something. He's not tripping, 100%.
And then I reckon pretty much then there was that, like you said, you didn't even say anything. I didn't say anything. I was just looking at you like, listen, cunt. Listen. Oi!
Stop.
You listening? And I reckon there was, like, a little bit of the old silence. We did something. And then suddenly again, like,
for sure. And then there was another.
This motherfucker ran through those cans, right? And I shit you not, we both looked at each other with fucking eyes the size of a fucking raccoon. Like, what the fuck is in?
And he must have shit himself.
Yeah, bro, I shit you not, and I swear it was one of those things where we looked at each other, and it was like I didn't even need a fucking. We didn't even need to talk, but it was that sort of thing where we were both just looking at each other, going. There's a monster in the fucking cupboard.
Yeah, it wasn't just a mouse, man.
Whatever the fuck is in that cupboard is fucking big, man. Yeah. Like, I don't know, like, there's a fucking possum or a human or a fucking something huge. Yeah, is like, in the thuds were loud.
Like, they were banging plates.
I think
plates.
I might have even said that to you, like, right before it all went down. I think, like, we looked at each other. There might have even been, like, another bit of a sound or we waited or whatever. And I just turned around and you go, bro, that's fucking big. And you just
big.
Probably still in and your days
this,
was sort of just,
time,
like... didn't say much, but just...
Well,
like,
I've just woken up, and then I've heard this thud that sounds like a fucking human in our cupboard, and I was just like, no way, like, there's no fucking way. So I'm just straight away pretty intrigued in that sense, so I've jumped up and had a little bit of a, like, poke the head over into the kitchen, like, what the fuck's going on, where is this noise coming from, and how did you get in there? And so I'm walking over, just slowly making my way, and this motherfucker, I looked over at the kitchen sink,
and like, is this the point where we explain what it was? This motherfucker?
Yeah, well, I guess because, probably because where it come from is like...
At this point, it's almost like, is there a buffalo in our thing? Like, it's a fucking cat, it's a dog, it's a human, this thing sounds massive.
Yeah, it's a fucking snake.
And
I'm like, Jesus Christ.
And like, at the end of the day, yeah, it was, because like that... Go on.
It was huge. But, so I've jumped, put my head over, and this thing is a fucking rat, right? It's a rat, and it's not just a mice with a big tail or an oversized fat mice. It was a fucking rat. Huge. It looked like a little mini, like, I don't know, rabbit. It honestly looked like a rabbit or like some sort of marsupial that had a bit of size to it.
Proper.
The fucking thing jumps from the bench, like off the sink, to the center of the kitchen floor, so I'm standing
which
on the...
Which still makes no sense. We don't know how it even got to that point.
No,
like,
okay,
how did it
it's,
get out?
I think it's
it
come from,
out
like,
of the cupboard.
In the sink, but where I seen, where I caught eye contact with it, it was almost, like, half mid-flight off the bench.
Yeah.
And by that time, I couldn't see where it come from, but it makes sense. It would have had to come from underneath, but it just... I don't know how, because one of the cupboards didn't open and shut.
Yeah.
And it was that big, it would have had to have.
I think, too, it was one of those things where it was like, you know when you know but you don't want to know? Like, the whole time we were like, that's a big mouse in that fucking... But it was more just like, I don't want to believe that there's a fucking big rat. And until it was, like, that point where it did jump out, that was when it was like, this is real.
Yeah.
And I guess that's where, like, I knew I was fucking done.
Yeah, so it's on the ground. Like, it's jumped off the bench. It's hit the fucking center of the kitchen floor. And I'm like, fuck, now it's on. Like, I'm trying to play fucking keep the rat in the paddock in the kitchen with me feet and that's it. And then it's fucking darted between me legs, piss bolted.
We did a couple of laps in the kitchen. It's sort of like
went doing
from
circle
like fridge
work.
To wall, fridge to wall. And then that's what, like, on that too, like, I'm a little bit scared of him.
I'm getting to that. He's scared as fuck of him.
Like, at that point, I was already like, like I was sort of saying, like, I already, it was like subconsciously I knew there was a fucking rat in there. I didn't want to know. But as soon as I'd seen it, it was like, it's fucking real. I'm scared, but like sort of do something. So you would sort of, all I remember was sort of yelling at you to be like, keep it in the kitchen. I don't know how or why we expected that to happen, but that was what my mentality was at the start. And then it was like, we had nothing to, no tools or anything to attack it with. We're just
let's have my fucking feet, man. And
so,
it was a rat.
But I just remember sort of, keep it in there, man, keep it in there. I like sort of remember thinking, I'll try to find something. This is all happening in like 2 seconds. It literally all happened in fucking 2 seconds. Whereas he's darting back and forth in the kitchen, and then he sort of, I guess he fucking does the old fucking double pass on you, doesn't he? And he
left, right, and I was like, fuck. And then it was right, and it was straight down the hallway, and I was like, my bedroom door's right there, and it's open.
Yeah.
And because it was night, the hallway went dark, and by the time it just went in there, it was disappeared, it had gone. So I was like, fuck, it's in my room, fuck, oh, shit.
Yeah.
And then, like, I just stopped, and I could hear something going on, but it wasn't my room. It was down the very end of the house, and that's Borgs' room, and Carby was in the room, in bed, and this rat's fucking gone, fucking Mac one into his room. Carby's fucking alert, what the fuck's that? And he's up against the wall, like, trying to pin it. So I've ran down there. While this is all going on, Borgs is up in the kitchen still, fucking like preparing for when this fucking thing just...
I wasn't going down there.
Straight down the end of the hallway at him. So I'm
at this point too, I'm down the other end of the hallway. I've fucking grabbed a fucking random shovel from the front, given it to fucking Schmidt and been like, this is what you fucking do with it. I'm staying here. I'm not fucking going anywhere near
it. Telling me this is what you do with it when he won't go anywhere fucking near it.
So anyway, next thing you know, he's in my room with this rat and me dog trying to chase it. I'm down the other end of the hallway, sort of like, what's happening? Yeah, hey, what's happening? Did you get it? Like, I'm ready to...
Shut the fuck up, man. I'm still trying to kill it.
I'm fucking car and burn the fucking house down. Seriously, I'm sitting there seriously considering, like, this cunt's in my fucking room. I'm not fucking going back in my room. I'm done. I'm fucking getting me swag. I'm going to my parents. I'm sleeping on the fucking... on their couch or something. I'm not doing this. I'll sleep in my car. I'm not fucking doing this, man. Like, fuck this. So I'm at the other end of the hallway freaking out. And I can't see anything. So, like, all I can hear is Carby sort of burp every now and then. And Schmidt be like, get it, fucking push it out. And I'm like, righto, this is fucked.
And I couldn't see it this whole time because it was up under, like, a box or something up near his bed, in between his bed and the wall. And he's fucking, Carby's in the way and, like, fucking there, left, right, trying to get this thing out. And then next minute, it's just fucking piss bolted straight off the wall. Straight at me, but past me, up on another wall, did a bit of a semi-wall ride, like, used the fucking two corner of the walls as a berm,
and
bounced off one.
I'd see, like, I could see it from that.
Yeah, point. It was so back in your view.
Yeah, so I'm straight down the hallway, rooms at the end, and the next thing I know, like, I'm just watching, waiting for anything to fucking happen. Next thing you know, this little, it was a fucking...
Yeah, when the size of it, that's what I was just thinking in my head. I reckon I could easily put my size 9, 10 shoe next to it. And it would be a lot bigger.
Yep.
It would be not a lot bigger. It would have been.
It was shoey.
Yeah, it was. Like, it was even quite, even its shape.
It was quite shoe like. Anyway, this fucking shoe comes running it like comes into my vision in my room, like runs into like the corner of my room, rides up the wall, 2 foot. Like I'm gonna fucking get up this wall. Can't make it. Loses grip, falls down, turns the fuck around and. Faces me down this hallway, cunts. I'm talking like he's just
like a bull, man.
And just he's come down this hallway and he's done like that rat double jump. Man, this thing's coming down the fucking hallway, and I shit you not.
I've never heard a grown man scream like this as much as he did. And usually he's pretty good at over exaggerating. He's either his crashes or his pain or his. He's whatever it is, he's pretty good at over exaggerating. But I didn't even fucking laugh to a point when he started because I could hear the fear in this motherfucker's voice, right?
I was scared, man. I was like, this little cunt, and I just scream. Like, because that's what I sort of say. Like,
and standing on the coffee table.
That's what's funny. Like, I do have this, I don't like critters, little animals. So, like, I do get a little bit. If there was a mouse, I wouldn't be absolutely terrified. If it was on me, you'd hear the real fear. But I have, like, if it's over there, I'll sort of, like, I'll be a bit comical and be like, you know, throw a bit of a fuck that, get the fucking cunt away from me. I don't like anything to do with it. This, though, I'm talking, it was that sort of thing where I actually didn't even realize I was doing it. I blanked out the hole when it ran down the fucking hall, it come hawking down the fucking hallway. I'm screaming, watching it till about halfway. Then I realise I'm standing in its way. I'm fucking gone, cunt. Right, so I fucking run halfway into the fucking kitchen area, jump up on the fucking coffee table, still squealing my fucking guts out, right?
Like consistent.
Squealing, right? This little cunt's come fucking hooking into the fucking kitchen, come fucking hooking past me, almost like around the corner of the coffee table.
I'm chasing it with a shovel.
This cunt's coming out the fucking hallway behind it. Just ran under the TV unit. I'm still fucking squealing. Like, proper fucking... Like, man, I don't know if I could even do it because it was that... Like, I feel like it was one of those things too. Like, I sort of... It was... I didn't even realize I was screaming like that until I...
No, and I could tell that. That's why I didn't laugh at you, man. Because I could tell you had no control over your fear.
I was just like...
That's exactly... That's like, exactly, and I was almost like, dude, shut the fuck up. I'm trying to concentrate to kill this cunt. And here he is, and I'm like, it's not a joke anymore. And then I turn around and realize he wasn't joking.
Sort of. Like, I was just like, I don't want to be here anymore. Like, just fucking terrified. And then technically too, that was sort of the last we'd seen of it. It ran under the fucking TV unit in there, which ends up technically
in the podcast.
He came
room.
Out into the, so he's come straight into here, and the whole, it's endless. Long story short, the morning after, Schmidt hears a bit of banging. This little cunt's knocked down one of me fucking paintings and a bunch of bloody stormtroopers. So he's obviously been in this room for a little bit. That morning we got up, because this is like I said, it was 2 o'clock at night. We were like, whatever. We've shooed this cunt into that room. We'll shut all the doors and make sure what the fuck's going on, and we'll fucking sleep the night and sort some traps and shit out in the morning. Got up the next morning, thing had fallen down, made some noise and shit. We were like, he's definitely fucking in here. Let's go get some poison. Let's go get some traps. Let's sort that out. Went and sorted all that out, set it all up. Cool bananas.
But yeah,
he's fucking still in the roof, this cunt.
Yeah, but that, I guess that's what I was going to say. He came from the roof, and we've figured out in the roof he can get in and out of the roof, not a problem. So he's probably been up there, and he's coming and going, getting his food and his drink and his all the shit that he gets from outside, coming back into his warm roof. But then he's obviously slipped down into the house and realized, like, fuck, I've never been in here, and now there's two motherfuckers that want to kill me in here. I'm out.
Yeah.
And then he stayed that night, and then I know he's back up in the roof now because I could hear him this morning doing a couple of fucking hot laps.
Yeah.
But other than that, I think he's gone, fuck, I'm not going back there. I'm back up in my house. I'm not going back down there. So I think we're pretty right in that sense. Well, I'm telling myself we're pretty right in that sense.
Same. Because if it's not, I'd be burning the fucking joint down because...
Yeah.
Going back on it, I don't know what it is. I don't know why I have this weird, because it's when it comes down to, you know, fears, it is a weird one, because it's like, it's obviously some sort of fear, because it does, it scares the fuck out. And it's like a little rodent thing. Like, even, you know, any sort of mouse, rat, fucking probably a fucking little raccoon, even a, I feel like a possum's just solid enough for me. But if that cunt ran at me, I'd fucking be terrified.
But even a bird.
But yeah, like birds are a big one. Birds are a double whammy. I feel like I can breathe through a bird if the bird's chill. Like if I'm in a small space and the bird's flapping around, freak out. But I don't know what, like, it's just a weird, it has to be some, like, I must have copped some shit in a past life. Fell in some fucking trapdoor that was just full of mice, and I just died in mice while they just ate me.
Maybe.
You know, like, because where does that come from? Like, I mean, I do have past experiences. I'm going to get deep in that, like, you know, living at 68, I had a little bit of an experience where it wasn't a little bit, it was a full-blown experience. So I'm in bed doing my thing, tucked up in bed with, like, the doona, you know, you sort of, like, have the doona, like, half over your face, sort of, and you're all snugged in and that. Here I am, just minding my own business, trying to go to sleep. Next thing I know, and the little cunt come from behind. So it was like I heard the first two little on me bed. And it was like, what the fuck was that? And then I felt this cunt, man, just fucking over me face, zip over, like, do a little hustle over me face, jump over me face, and keep going. Now, that was a fucking ordeal. I don't think that's what freaked me out, because, to be honest, I think I was a little bit... Oi! Can you not do that while we're in the middle of a fucking... Stop! No! That, I don't think, is the reason why I'm... I think it's deeper than that. It really is. I do have, like, a deep... Get off me. Like, and it is. It's like I'm... It's on me. I don't give a fuck if they're over there. The fear is them coming near me and crawling on me. I think that is my biggest fear, and I don't know where it comes from. I don't know if some weird shit's happened.
I think we all get it.
Well, yeah, it probably is, and then I guess you've just got to have certain things that overcome it maybe when you're young, and I didn't have those certain things. So,
and some people can deal with those things a whole lot easier than what you can.
But I guess, you know, if you grow up on a farm hanging around... Shut up!
Carby's just acting up. He reckons he's going to fucking get all the birds.
Yeah, it's probably something.
Motherfucker doesn't have wings, though.
Bird outside that he thinks he's going to chase for no reason. And what did you say then, again? I've lost it, haven't we?
The fear thing, I've lost it, man.
Fuck.
It's such a sidetrack thing.
This is hard, guys. I'm just telling you now, if you're thinking about doing a podcast, it can be quite a...
challenging, on the man. Brain, like, challenging.
Yeah, especially at fucking 6 o'clock in the morning when you pretty much just wake up, walk down and start talking shit. Like, we didn't even say anything to each other this morning. Like, we might have just grunted at each other, but it was super... like, it's almost like I don't even want to bother talking to this cunt now because it's still that early. But then you come in here and you're like, full go, full steam ahead. I've got to have a fucking full-blown conversation. What are we looking at, 44 minutes? Well, we're going up bad. I think leading into the whole rat, I think fear is something that... it's just a good little topic that we can bounce off for a little bit here because it is a weird... It's definitely a weird sort of thing that... that's what it was. It was people being able to work through that fear easily, you know.
Yeah,
say you grew up on a farm.
Yeah,
if you grew up on a farm, you're probably way easier to deal with rats and birds.
Yeah, for sure. Or you just... some people are just better with dealing with those things. They don't worry them. Like, for me, I don't like it. I didn't like having the rat in the house, don't get me wrong.
Yep.
But I could deal with it to try and get the cunt out.
Yeah.
If you were in here by yourself, you probably would have not even been able to get it. You would have got yourself out and just let it deal with itself in the house. You would have been like, I'm out.
Mm. Well, we're just bit.
So some people, it's easier to do, like, to understand and control the brain in a
fearful situation.
Like that.
Yeah, I guess so. And I guess that's probably the biggest thing with, it's like, yeah, like...
where you'd be better at controlling your brain in a different situation than what I would with something else.
Yeah.
I'd fold and you'd be like, what are you doing, man? I got it.
Yeah.
Not a deal.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, fuck that.
Yeah.
You can have it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's fucking weird, those things. It is that certain... and I guess there's, you know, the only thing is to just, you know, is to push up, face those fears. Like, as much as I don't want to have anything to do with mice, rats, or even birds particularly, but, you know, to get through that fear, you know, some going to a bloody bird sanctuary is probably something that will help that. Being around a bunch of birds that are flapping their wings and I can just be comfortable to be like, there's nothing about this that actually scares me. I'm just scared of the thought of it.
Yep,
and that's fear, dudes. That is honestly what fear is, and it's literally just a big old wall there to stop you doing
things.
It can just come
in so many different shapes and sizes, I fear.
Oh.
Like, you know, it's just one thing, it's from doing what you love, let's say.
You
might do something that scares the absolute fuck through you.
Yep.
Or you might, same as a rodent, pest, whatever, they might scare you. So you just stay the fuck away from them. Some people chase the fear and some people try and steer clear of the fear.
Yeah.
Where, yeah, I guess regardless of the way you go about your life and fear, you're going to come into contact with it.
And you do, the truth be told, the best option is to sort of face it. There's no point in living through this life and being scared of...
the scaredest people in the world will tell you to face your fears.
Yeah.
Because they know that it's hard for them to do it, but they know that it's the only way to overcome something like that.
And it is. It's you like, I don't know. The other side of fear is fucking awesome. I'm a chaser of it. Like, you know, like I don't, like I said, I'm not going to go out of my way to be like patting rats, but because it's just not what I like. But
it's not a thrill.
Things,
it's a fear.
Exactly. Where like there's thrills that have a fear attached to them, and once you get over that fear, that thrill is hell
amazing.
Of a thrill. Yeah,
hell
and
yeah.
I think fear is just, and I, you know, I think fear can be misunderstood a lot.
Mm.
Fear, you, a lot of the time you probably don't even realize you're scared of something until, going back on what we were talking about before, you start making up weird excuses. That's when you're going to realize that you're scared of something. When you're like, I can't do this because of that. Or I can't do this because of that.
Mm.
Well, no, you can't do that because you're fucking terrified of it. Like, and that's not a bad thing. That's like a natural human thing for us to push further and be, you know, if everything was easy, we'd all be doing it. Like, things need to be scary. If you're, you know, skydiving, it has to be like, whoa, this is scary. But, you know, once you do it, it's fucking hell worth it.
And I think finding out what can keep that fear under control and what you're scared of under control isn't bad, isn't like a thing like, oh, fuck, I wish I wasn't scared of this. No, take it on and be like, fuck, well, I'm scared of it. Too bad. I'm going to figure it out and try and understand it the best and what coping mechanisms you can use when you come into contact with that fear. That's one of the biggest things, to be able to control your fucking brain in a situation where the brain tries to control itself and go spastic. If you can do that, no matter what your fear is, you will realize that you've probably got a hell of a lot more control now over it than what you did before when you just fucking scream or freak out or fucking the things you do.
You've got to see that fear too, I think.
And be like, okay, this is why it's happening.
Know that, all right, I am scared of that. It's a little bit fucking, it freaks me out a little bit. Why? Work it out. Find the thingos. Just do little things to be like, all right, I'm not as scared anymore. You know, if you're scared of heights, have a ladder out the back and just one step a day. You don't need to climb straight to the top of the ladder at the start. It's understanding that at the end of the day, you know how scary it is at the top, but working through it, you'll be able to stand at the top of that ladder and not be scared.
And being able to realize that, yes, you know how scary it will be up at the top, but you've never fucking been up the top. And it's only your brain telling you how scared you would be. Once you're there, you can control that. Like I was saying before, knowing what is up with it, and being like, okay, maybe I can just breathe, let's say, or maybe I could, you know, there's mechanisms for all these things, and they might sound stupid or feel stupid, but they fucking work.
Yeah.
And if you ain't willing to try that because you feel stupid, well, that's your loss. You're going to be fucking shit scared for the rest of your life, so fucking deal with it.
And, you know, I think, like, with fear too, I feel like, you know, like, you've got to let go of a lot to then enter the fear gates. I think you can't just enter the fear gates with all this baggage. You need to let go of everything and face that fear with just you. You can't sort of, because otherwise it goes back into that excuse. You're not really doing it for the right reasons. It's all just sort of, you've got to have that genuine focus to know why you're going in there and let everything else go and be like, I'm going to attack this and I'm going to attack it with everything I've got. Not sort of like, just don't half-ass it. Just don't half-ass anything. If you're going to go do shit, fucking go hard.
Pretty much, Shano. I think that's more of to the point. Just don't half-ass shit, man.
Yeah. And honestly, too, I'm a big, like, chase those fears. Trust me when I say the other side is fucking way better than being just scared of things. It's
definitely. And if you put yourself in the position of the things you know you shit yourself on and you're really scared of, if you put yourselves there and don't let yourself get there and find that, and then it's then sprung on you and like, oh, fuck, now I'm in this scared situation, so I am scared. If you can kind of put yourself in there or purposely try and, put yourself in a situation that makes you scared or whatever, you will then realize it's better to deal with and get a bit of control behind whatever that is. Like, don't just let yourself come in. If you're scared of bloody mice, don't let yourself fucking just walk into a room and then there's mice in there or something, you know? Like, try and condition yourself to it a bit. If it is such a big fear, go and condition yourself. Well, not even get one. Just go and see. Like, I know people that are shit scared of spiders, but they'll go to somewhere and have someone, like a trained spider person, put a spider on their arm and let it crawl up and over their fucking shit. And by the time they leave, they're conditioned a little bit better than what they were when they got there.
Totally, 100%.
So I think if you can put yourself in those positions and, you try and beat the scare, I guess. Beat it to it, if that makes sense. Yeah. Get to it before it comes to you.
I think too with fear, it's very easy to almost just put fear into. Fear's a huge thing and it's not just physical things, you know, like you can be scared to talk to someone. You can be scared to admit something. You can be scared, and these are all fears. Like you can be scared for everyone to find out the truth about what you really did that time.
Yeah, you don't want to tell someone about something because you're scared of what they'll think of, you know, you or the thing you've done. Like,
that's way louder on this side, isn't it?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Look at that, would you look at that? But yeah, fear, it does, it comes in all different sort of ways, and you've got to be able to read it and be like, you've got to be able to read yourself to be like, that's fear telling me to do that, not anything else. I'm making up these excuses. I'm saying I can't do this because of fear, and it's because I'm scared to go down and see that person or talk to that person or try out for this new job or like it's endless. There's so many different situations where fear just steps in and sort of like persuades you the opposite way. And it's very easy to just take its hand and go, fuck, you know what? I like being comfy and I'm going to go over there and be comfy with Mr. Fear over there. But the key to it is it's way more exciting when you push those limits. And like on the other side of fear, it is. It's fucking beautiful.
Yeah, it really is. Like it definitely is.
It's majestic shit on the other side of fear, man.
Yeah, the nice part of fear definitely makes you work for it.
Yeah.
When you're dealing with just the fear.
Yeah.
But then, yeah, it's all good on the other side, that's for sure. Mm. It's usually the way of life. The things that are good and the things you want are really hard to get, or they make you work real hard to fucking get them.
And, like, it should be. Nothing good should come easy.
100%.
You know, like, that's what we're here for. Like, I don't know what makes you think you're fucking special enough to be like, oh, it's like I'm a miracle to be a fucking human being in one, and I should just have everything given to me. Like, you've got fucking a body, arms, legs, muscles, a brain. Fucking use them, cunt. Like, the fact that we're just so fucking, like...
And I know in that sense, just fucking use them, like, it's pretty crippling when you're scared of something.
Oh, yeah, it can be.
Like,
yeah,
you on the coffee table with the fucking rat. Like, fuck that was... For you to pull... In that instance, for you to pull yourself out of that, scared, I'm fucking shitting, and go, let's... Hang on a minute, it's just a rat. It's not so bad. Schmidt's fucking chasing it. Seems to be not too bad. If he can do that, maybe I could do that too. Like, I don't need to be up here. For you to do that then and there, would have been fucking hard, man.
Yeah.
You probably wouldn't have done it.
When you, and I think that's the biggest thing. Like, when you're surrounded by the fear, it becomes way harder. You need to, like, you need to see that fear outside of the fear and be like, oh, that's a fear.
Mm.
Not like, I'm in it, I'm fucking terrified. You're not going to see through it then. You're too deep.
Hell no. You're terrified. And that's what I mean by putting yourself in and around it.
Yeah.
Because you can kind of, you can adjust to it at your level. They're not coming at you and making you shit yourself to the 100%.
But I guess then there's almost like, I just think of that of like, you know, of what's happening in these times. The fear mongering, the planning ideas in everyone's head to make them be in fear of just everything. Literally just leaving their house. They're making us scared to leave our house. And like, truth is, when you leave your house, there's nothing to be scared of.
Mm.
Like, oh, buzzing out hard there.
Interference.
Yeah. It was.
Yeah.
Your phone. So they are, you need, you might be stuck in the fear trap of what's going on the news and all that stuff and be terrified of like, oh, the riots are going to come here and then Corona's going to get me and then all this stuff. Like at the end of the day, if you're deep in that, it's always going to be fucking scary. You need to take a little bit of a step out of it, look at it from the outside and be like, hold on a minute. That doesn't make much sense.
Mm.
But that's because the whole situation at the moment doesn't make much sense. And if you can make sense of it, that isn't just some bullshit.
Give us a call. I'd love to hear it.
Yeah, if I can get a few phone calls on the... Maybe we should take some calls. Hey, guys, welcome to the My Die Podcast. We got caller number one here. What do you got?
Yeah, guys, fucking Travis here. First time caller.
Love your show,
listener.
Boys.
Love you, boy. Yeah, love fucking. I'd just like to know. Fucking. I don't know.
But hey, here's the bus. Maybe we need to get. We'll get a landline or something.
My die phone.
Fucking oath. But look, we are pushing. What are we at? We're at 58 minutes.
And I gotta go to work. Legit, jeez. Gotta go to work.
What's the time?
8:31.
8:31, you definitely do. I need to get some shit sorted and, yep, I wouldn't mind making myself a smoothie because I'm a little bit, I'm getting a little bit hungry, so I wouldn't mind punching a big old smoothie down.
Fuck yeah, Shano loves his smoothies, he'll tell you too.
I love smoothies now, man. I love smoothies, bro.
Yeah, fuck yeah, nice. They're a lovely thing. They're a lovely thing, especially in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Good shit. Righto, well, we'll leave yous on that, ladies and gents. Thanks for tuning in once again.
Lost the camera.
There too, so we are, it's perfect timing.
Bloody
yes, once again, thank you for all the support. Cheers to everyone. You know where to go, bloodylivediefree.com, patrons/mightdie. If you want to jump on there, get that support going. On that note, if you are a bunch of patrons listening, I am sorting out the patron t-shirt this weekend, so that is another thing that's been on the back burner that's been pretty gnarly, but
it's just all been full on, man.
A lot been going on, my dudes, but we're slowly getting there. We're getting it done, and we are done on another one. Here we are,
buddy.
Podcast
number six. We are done and dusted.
See you all next week. Thanks again. Whoop whoop.
Catches.
Ew! Stop. Oh, where's my mouse? We're still here, ladies and gentlemen.
Fucking look at that.
They've even taken my headphones off.
I didn't have my mouse and I couldn't press stop, so we're still here. Here's a little one for you.